Right, Brad and Erica, Roberto Escobar worked at the line at this plant for more than a decade before he tested positive for COVID-19 and soon died. He's one of the employees who said that this plant should have shut down weeks before it did. 37-year-old Roberto Escobar made the trip to this plant for 14 years. His final journey this morning was from the hands of the director at the Martinez funeral home and into the arms of his widow.
Era mi pareja.
His partner, Gabriela Hernandez, and wife of 9 years. Hernandez told me her husband started wearing a mask very early in March, but was discouraged by a supervisor. Escobar was worried about his health, but continued working because he didn't want to lose his job.
Antes de que él sintiera los síntomas,
she says, he told me there's people that are out because they have symptoms, but the company's not saying anything and they're not protecting us. His symptoms began in mid-April and he soon tested positive. He died on May 1st.
Llamé a la ambulancia y vinieron por él.
She told me, the ambulance picked him up and we never saw him again. Hernandez and several other current employees tell the CBS2 investigators they're now aware of 4 virus-related deaths. Hernandez argues that El Milagro should have closed long before the first death on April 26th. This current employee who asked us not to reveal his identity agrees.
Need to be a safe place for everyone.
He said that even with extensive social distancing precautions in place, he did not feel safe. When he tested positive for COVID-19, he says they required him to send a doctor's note to excuse him from his shifts.
Feel more human, because I think sometimes they only see the workers like a replaceable part, like a machine.
In a letter to employees, El Milagro said their protocols were consistent with guidance from the CDC and that employees had the option to wear their own masks before they were provided. Hernandez believes the precautions should have been taken sooner. Now, we spoke to several employees for this story, but many were not willing to be interviewed for fear of losing their jobs. I did reach out to El Milagro about their concerns. So far, we have not heard back. I should mention that this lockdown, or the shutdown, I should say, was completely voluntary.
Megan, the plant reopened yesterday after a deep cleaning, but what else is the company going to do now to stop the spread?
Erica, so the company says they're going to be requiring employees to wear masks inside the building. They've also already installed partitions and staggering the start of shift times. So far, we do not have an exact number of cases or COVID-related deaths attributed to this building.
Okay, CBS2 investigator Megan Hickey, thank you.